You know how people play this game, Two Truths and a Lie? I changed 5 countries in my childhood without moving from my hometown. And people think it's a lie, but it's actually a truth. I am Serbian. I was born in the early 80s, grew up in the 90s, and 90s in the Balkans were a rough patch for the place. When you're faced with this, some people either develop in a deeply distrustful of the world. On my side, I actually developed some of the opposite sentiments, and I became one of the most optimistic people I know. I started playing games, I got into fantasy role-playing as well, I played D&D, and I got into physics. It happened at a summer camp for physics, and the topic of that night was double-slit experiment. Now, there's a whole, both physics and metaphysics around it, interpretations as well. I know the message, and I remember it clearly, of that night is that if you don't do a measurement, your electron or a photon goes one direction, it has one pattern. And then if you do a measurement, then it exhibits a different pattern. And I was mind-blown. You imagine you're 13 years old, and for my kind of kid's mind, there was a science fiction part that I could really get behind and think about. And I was very lucky there, because I think I knew I was going to be a physicist. And in these many years of doing this, I've never really encountered something else that I would rather be. I finished my undergrad in Belgrade, so I started working on optics and optical measurements of some superconductors at a time in Belgrade. Just in general, quantum technology changed my life, but also the time when I entered was pretty fortunate. I think I was just lucky to develop an affinity in something that would maybe 5 to 10 years later start exploding when it comes to also commercial interest, not only scientific interest. I've been at SandboxAQ since almost the beginning. This small team of, I think it was like 6 or 7 people that was based in Google X. The call came from Jack and Stefan Leichenauer, who were building their core team, and they wanted me to come tomorrow to start the quantum sensing lab. And this is a Silicon Valley mantra. Send something you're ashamed of, but send it fast. I remember sending our first NV Diamonds MCG system to UCSF. We sent it, and it failed spectacularly. I was heartbroken because I wanted to build an NV sensor because that was my bread and butter. And all of a sudden, we're not building NV sensors anymore. What is my value here, right? So you do need to be ready to release yourself from a certain persona and step into what is needed for the project. So at that point, I think once we decided we are not an NV sensor magnetometer company, we are a medical device company or a team. At that point, there is a mind shift. And at that point, anything goes. I've seen us grow from a small team of a handful of people to a really like super agile startup that we are right now. And I've seen us mature from a research organization filled with young PhDs playing on with experiments to a more very mature company that's really focused on product execution. And we started a lot of different projects. So when people ask me today, what binds together cybersecurity product, simulations using classical computer but simulating quantum binding models, navigation with using AI and magnetic maps and measuring cardiovascular disease with quantum, well, the answer is these four showed rapid technology climb up the technology readiness level ladder and enough forecast the commercial impact to survive. It would be difficult to find a higher impact than tackling the world's number one killer, which is cardiovascular disease. In short, as the electrical currents flow through your heart, they create magnetic fields. This actual electrical field is what you measure in electrocardiogram that's been around for 100 years or so. Basically, you're putting pads on your body and you're measuring electric field that propagates through your heart. And the problem is that it gets attenuated, it gets distorted, and you don't get a faithful response. So the advantage of measuring magnetic fields is that human body is transparent for magnetic fields. So if you can measure magnetic field, you would be able to diagnose or kind of detect problems with upcoming cardiovascular diseases much earlier, much better. This is not a new technology. However, it has been basically unknown to the field of cardiologists because the systems needed to measure magnetic fields of the heart are incredibly large and expensive. They require a large shielded room. So what we were looking for is that we said, okay, the proof of impact is there, but technology is lacking. Can we look at the new technologies coming up, new sensors that don't require shielded room, that don't require cryogenic cooling, and see if they can be incorporated into this new generation of MCG systems that can be as powerful in detecting showing these maps, but they don't come with this baggage of $2 million shields or cryogenics. And patient comes in, they get an ECG, which they must do, they get their blood drawn, and they have their MCG as well. So you get your first line of defense tools, but using a system that's as advanced as the more sophisticated tools that would come later as well. And this allows you to allocate your resources more efficiently, to keep patients on monitoring, to release patients that are healthy, to not go into extremely expensive or invasive procedures. This is really the goal. And to build it in a way where you can deploy it in every hospital, that this advanced diagnostic is not tied only to Mayo Clinic and Mount Sinai or so, but that you can send it to rural hospitals, resource-constrained centers, and allow people there to have access to such advanced diagnostics. At AQMed, we have a set of values that we want to conduct ourselves with and that guide our everyday work. Human impact, guided by science, is one that resonates very deeply. And I have found meaning in developing something that can touch people's lives, that has impact. So right now I find myself at a place where I will not be able to work on something that has no impact. My name is Stefan Bogdanovic. I work at SandboxAQ. We are building a next generation heart scanner for early and accurate detection of heart attacks for anyone, anywhere in the world.